So what are a couple of the things that are unique to the zone of totality? When the moon completely covers the disk of the sun, you're going to get to see several really neat effects. The first one I think is really cool is called Bailys Beads. These are bright little spots that you'll see around the edge of the moon. It turns out the moon is not flat. The moon has mountains. Some of those mountains are almost as tall as Mount Hood here in Oregon, 8,000 or 9,000 feet tall. And as the very last moments of the moon moving in front of the sun, sunlight can come through the valleys in between these individual mountain peaks. Those bright spots you see called Bailys Beads are exactly that, as sunlight coming through individual mountain peaks on the moon, something you'll see during totality. Another wonderful thing that you're going to see, and something as an astronomer I'm personally very excited to talk about and see, is the corona of the sun. The corona is the outer atmosphere of the sun. By the way, it's out there today, but you can't see it because the disk of the sun is so bright it washes it out. But during the time that the moon completely covers the disk of the sun, you'll get to see this wispy, bright upper atmosphere of the sun, which, by the way, is 4 or 5 times bigger than the sun is in the sky. And the third thing I want to make sure that everybody realizes you'll get to see in totality, the stars and the planets are going to come out. Again, as an astronomer, that's something I'm very excited about. And the eclipse is going to happen in the constellation Leo. And Leo has a very bright star named Regulus. And Regulus is going to be just a couple degrees from the sun. And so you're going to get to see literally a 2-minute night in the morning of August 21st.